Hey folks, this is Backyard Observatory with a product review. Now, having some experience with taking a box cam based on an Aptina 130 sensor, just like the ASI220, and making a micro mini guider, and my experience with the ArduCam 3.2mm lens, which if you've seen my 4K all sky time lapse, that's the lens I used. I felt fairly confident in purchasing this camera. I mean, the housing looked good. It had HR264 support, had a mic in it, but that, you know, not critical. But if I wanted to live stream the natural ambient sounds from the yard, you know, I could. And what really sold me was the response to this question. What is the longest single frame exposure this camera can take when controlled by UVC? Is it possible to capture up to 30-second exposures? UCtronics, the official vendor for ArduCam, said when it's controlled by UVC, the longest actual exposure time is 1 second. So that kind of sold me, you know, 1 second, that works. I mean, I wasn't planning on doing any deep sky imaging with it. You know, maybe some casual solar, maybe a little bit of casual lunar, some planetary. You know, maybe, I don't know, splitting a couple binaries. It'd make for a great little, meteor detection all sky camera. Or, some visual satellite tracking. You know, 1 second exposure was just long enough for guiding. Plus, it was about 1/3 to 1/5 the price of a standard Astro cam based on the same sensor. So, I ordered one. The build materials were nice. It was a nice enclosure, had a nice little tripod. The camera actually came wrapped in that anti-static bag. Yeah, it was pretty decent. So it was off to go hook it up. So first off, the 2.8 to 12 millimeter lens will not focus at infinity between about 2.8 millimeters and about 5 millimeters. To reach infinity focus, you actually have to unscrew the lens until it almost falls out. I took my vertier calipers, did a measurement, and the gap is less than the difference between a C mount and a CS mount, so you can't use a C to CS mount adapter to reach infinity focus at 2.8. So that's the first problem. But, I didn't really care about the lens all that much. I might find a use for it, but how the camera functioned was pretty important. So here we are. The camera's hooked up to AMCAP. This is my backyard under a 3/4 moon, slightly overcast, but there's a ton of local light pollution. Now we're going to take a look at the properties here just to make sure I'm not doing anything wrong. The camera, all the settings are at default. It's at auto exposure. So started wondering and went back into the options and looked at the capture format. And well, H.264 support is not there in AMCAP. So wanted to make sure that the audio was recording just to test the mic. Went in, double check the properties. Yes, gains all the way up. It's enabled. Now let's go back and make sure that the audio input and audio format are okay. So we're, recording at halfway decent bit rate. And let's start recording. This is the recording. This is me tapping on the camera itself and kind of yelling into it. Not so good. So I looked at the enclosure. There is no port opening for the mic. So there's no way to essentially allow sound to reach the mic directly. So I decided to load the camera up in SharpCap. Just to show that, it wasn't just AMCAP that was giving issues. Go back in, still kind of dark, no H.264 support. Now we'll go down, and it is in auto. Go over, double check, most MJPEG, you know, YUY2, but no H.264. No way to adjust the frame rates. The frame rates are locked. There's no way to adjust compression quality. Which, well, that part doesn't really surprise me, but go back in. And we are definitely on the default settings with the camera in auto mode. And it's still kind of dark. Again, this is with like a 3/4 moon. Now let's go over into low light compensation, which should be a gain boost or exposure boost or both, and no difference. Let's turn off the exposure, which is locked at 1/30th of a second. There we bumped up the gain, we bumped up the exposure, and wow, we can actually see pretty well, but it's only going up to 500 milliseconds. See, not getting the 1 second exposure. That's kind of sad because, you know, I can guide off of a 1 second exposure with this sensor, but not with this. So here's the test with better exposure. And as you can see, yeah, I shot this at 16 frames per second, about 60 milliseconds or so. Something's not right. I installed web diagnostics, webcam diagnostics, and looked at it. It shows from a hardware diagnostics aspect that H.264 support is there, but for some reason, I can't quite enable it in any software. I tried multiple pieces of software. So in conclusion, it fails as a webcam with a mic. The lens will not allow the wider angles to be used. While webcam diagnostic reports H.264 support, I could not find a single program that could access it. Its auto exposure mode is limited to 1/30th of a second maximum exposure, with no auto gain or low light compensation. So it fails at being a day-night camera or a low light camera. For budget Astro, I'd say it'd be okay for solar, lunar, and bright planetary as long as you manually set exposure and gain. However, I can't recommend it as a budget all-sky camera due to the auto exposure mode issue, or as a budget guide camera due to it lacking the 1 second exposure capability as stated by ArduCam's vendor. I will contact the vendor and ArduCam about the issues with this camera and update my review should the issues be resolved. It's a camera with a lot of potential should that happen. And that's my review of the ArduCam B0354. If you'd like to see more budget Astro alternatives and projects, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment. This is Backyard Observatory, wishing you clear skies and collimated optics.